Here is our King, here is our love, here is our God who's come to bring us back to Him. He is the one, He is Jesus. Whenever spring arrives to heal the ground, itself, trees of wine.
welcome to worship. Welcome to worship, folks who are joining us online tonight. It is so good to be together. However we've made our way to worship today, we're so glad you're here. Welcome. Whatever's been on your heart, whatever you've been carrying, and whatever's been weighing on you, you're invited to lay it down here. Rest and celebrate and worship the Lord. You are so loved. Let us begin our worship with a thanksgiving for baptism. Please rise as you are able. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are raised with him to new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and planted us in a well-watered garden. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us in still waters. At the cross, you watered us from Jesus' wounded side. On this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for your salvation through water. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy the thirsty, and give us the life only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Let's sing.
Rise up in love, shine with his glory. Jesus is raised and we shall arise. Rise up to live God's holy story. All things are being made new. Washed in the fog, God's Spirit has spoken, leading us through the darkness of life. Dripping with grace, sin's chains are broken. We are God's people. Not wasted, we are not bound by fear or despair. Feasting on love, we can all taste it. We are God's people of hope. Rise up in love, shine with his glory. Jesus is raised and we shall arise. Rise up to live God's holy story. All things are being made new. Christ is a trumpets are blowing, sorrow and pain are fading away. Shake off death's dust, creation is dawning. We are God's people of love. Rise up in love, shine with his glory. Jesus is raised and we shall arise. Rise up to live God's holy story.
Lord be with you. Let us pray together as one. Lord Christ, good shepherd of the sheep, you seek the lost and guide us into your fold. Feed us and we shall be satisfied. Heal us and we shall be made whole. Make us one with you, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated as we listen with new ears to God's word.
A reading from 1 John. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us. We ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide to anyone who has helped the world's goods and see a brother or sister in need and yet refuse help? Little children, let us love, not word or speech, but truth and action. By him, this we know that we are from the truth and reassure our hearts before him. Whenever our hearts condemn us, for God is greater than our hearts, and he knows anything, everything. Beloved, in our hearts, do not condemn us. We have boldness before God, and we receive him in whatever we ask, because we obey his commandments and do what pleases him. And in this commandment, we shall believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he commanded us. All who obey his commandments abide by him and abides by them. And by this we know that he abides by us, in the spirit that has given us, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks, Parker. At this time, we will prepare our hearts for a children's message by Jess.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
I hope you guys are doing so well. I'm so excited to be here with you virtually today. So, do any of you guys have a pet? Yeah, maybe some of you guys have a dog. Maybe some of you guys have a cat. Do any of you guys have a pet fish? Anybody have a pet guinea pig or hamster? Well, I am sure that maybe some of you guys even have multiple pets. Or if you don't, maybe one of your friends has a pet. So I have a pet dog. Her name is Bella. She's about like 7 years old. Some pictures are right here for you. I just love her so, so, so much. She is always so excited to see me. She always just wants to sit with you when you're like watching a movie. She knows when I'm sad. She is just my best friend. But why I'm asking you guys this today is because sometimes how we care for our pets is the same way that God cares for us. So in our scripture today, there's a phrase that says, God is my shepherd. He's a good shepherd. Do you guys know what a shepherd is? Kind of like a farmer. Like they take care of sheep usually. And they care for the sheep. They provide what they need. They provide food. They provide water. They provide shelter. And so just like I care for my dog, I care for Bella as I provide her treats. I provide her food. She doesn't have to worry about anything. She doesn't have to worry about really going for a walk, or she doesn't have to worry that she won't get this because I love her, I care for her, and I provide these things for her, right? Do you guys sometimes maybe help feed your pets? Do you guys ever take your pets for a walk or play with your pets? So you care for them because you love them, right? So in the same way that we do this for our pets, God cares for us because he loves us. We don't necessarily have to worry about some of the things that we get scared of or some of the things that we worry about on a day-to-day basis because God cares for you. God will provide everything that you need. He'll provide shelter. He'll provide food and water. He'll provide love because he loves you, because you are a child of God. So that is what I have to say today, is that you are loved. God will care for you. God does care for you, just like we care for our pets. So will you guys pray with me? Dear good and gracious God, we thank you that you are our good shepherd. Lord, we thank you for caring and for loving and providing everything that we need. God, we just ask that you would continue to pray or continue to sustain us and provide for us. And all God's children said, amen.
I invite you to stand as you are able. Let's sing and welcome the gospel. According to St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Grateful to be together with you this night and grateful for your worshiping with us online. I want to begin by sharing with you a little story from the genesis of Lutheran Church of the Cross. It's a part of the origin story of LCC. Now, there are not a lot of those original families, those founding families around anymore. It's been over 40 years since LCC started, and so that's what happened. So these stories are few and far between, and the ones that I know I cherish. So LCC started with a small group of people worshiping at Eastwood Elementary in the gym, right? And this was in 1980. And they had always intended to build their own church facility. And a part of that vision was they would build on this location right next to a Roman Catholic parish, right? A unique situation. The first of its kind in the country and maybe the world. I don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure also in the world. So just like any community looking to build a church facility, there was a building team and they had an architect and then eventually a contractor, and they were visiting one night about what the exterior of LCC's building would be. And they debated back and forth whether they would build with brick or with another material called Dryvit. If you don't know what Dryvit is, just think of like stucco. It's hard. It can be painted. So they weighed the pros and cons. Brick costs more money. It's longer lasting, more durable, but when there is needed maintenance, it's hard to match color, and it costs more to do that long-term upkeep. On the other hand, Dryvit was cheaper, easier to maintain. You could paint it any color, but it was prone to cracking and chips, and so they weighed the options, and ultimately, the LCC team decided they would build with Dryvit. It was such a small community, they were concerned they couldn't afford the brick. So because part of the vision of LCC was to build next to the Roman Catholic parish, their building committee would send members to the Catholic building committee as well. They were meeting during the same time talking about building Holy Cross Catholic, right, just across the courtyard. And they met together, the two teams, and LCC members said, well, we were weighing in the options between brick and Dryvit. We decided to go with Dryvit ultimately because of the cost. And Holy Cross members said, well, we kind of discussed it too, but we've chosen to go with brick. So they were at an impasse. From the very beginning, they had this shared vision to build two churches next to each other, to grow in mission, to grow in unity in the body of Christ, to be a witness, the first of its kind, of these two churches existing together and doing the work of the gospel together. So they left the meeting with different ideas, and they both went back to their respective building committees, and they went back to the LCC committee, and they said, well, Holy Cross is building with brick. So they went through it again and decided, we have to figure out how to come up with the extra money, because if we want to start out on the right foot. So a month goes by, and they meet with the building team again from Holy Cross, and they said, we've decided this is really important. We want our buildings on the outside to look the same, to look similar. And so we'll go with brick. And the Holy Cross member said, really? We met and decided we'll go with drive it. And both communities had a good laugh. But it was a witness to the beginning of shared mission. They both went back to their own groups and were willing to give up their own preference for the sake of unity. Because I think with some deep spiritual wisdom, the leaders of the communities know the vision for the place was unity in Christ. And if they could be trusted with unity in little things, like brick or drive it, maybe they could achieve the big, harder, more complex things, like unity in the body of Christ, even when there's disagreement and division. It's this idea of unity and self-interest that I read the gospel this day, this very familiar passage from John's gospel where Jesus refers to himself, he calls himself the Good Shepherd. I am the Good Shepherd. Now, if you ask a group of people, if you know anything about what Jesus refers to himself, how do you think of Jesus? How do you imagine his work in your life? Who is he? Many people on their short list would say he's the Good Shepherd. And this passage is known throughout Christianity. It's in music and it's in prayers and it's in art all over the place. From the earliest of Christian art right up to this moment standing right behind me on the stained glass. So when you worship at LCC or you're watching online, you see the image of this gospel passage every week, every time. Whether you're paying attention to it or not, you're soaking up this idea, this proclamation, the teaching that Jesus is the Good Shepherd. So I asked some new questions about the passage this week than I've asked before. Of course, I'm familiar with Jesus saying, I'm the Good Shepherd. But it struck me this week in a way that it has never before. Jesus identifies himself as the Good Shepherd, and he contrasts that with not a bad shepherd. He doesn't say, I'm the good shepherd, not like the bad shepherd, or the evil shepherd, or the shepherd who falls asleep watching the sheep, or the lazy shepherd, or the shepherd who doesn't know enough. It has nothing to do with another shepherd. Strangely, he contrasts himself with a hired hand. I found that really interesting. Why is that? Why does Jesus refer to himself as the good shepherd, but then tell us about the hired hand? Well, what do we know from Jesus? The hired hand, who's not the shepherd, he doesn't own the sheep. He doesn't care for the sheep. He sees a wolf coming. Since he doesn't own the sheep, he doesn't care for the sheep. He doesn't know the sheep. They don't know him. He doesn't know their names. He doesn't give them names. They don't really know his voice. The wolf comes. There's a threat. Boom, he's gone. He's out of there. In other words, his self-interest rises above his responsibility to those sheep. There's danger, there's risk involved, the hired hand's gone. Jesus says, I'm the good shepherd. I know the sheep. They know me. I know their names. They know my voice. I care for the sheep. I love the sheep. They are my sheep. There are other sheep who aren't a part of this community, of his flock, and I will bring them into, I will call them one flock, one shepherd. What happens when risk comes, when danger comes, when there's a threat to divide this flock, to separate it, to cause disunity? The shepherd intervenes. He lays down his life. Why? Jesus is teaching us the shepherd's primary focus, his goal, is unity in the flock. To hold the flock together, because what does the wolf do? Scatters them. The good shepherd, with his care, his love, his relationship, his community and communion with his flock, is to hold it together. Prevent it from scattering. I had often thought of the Good Shepherd, and maybe it's how you refer to the Good Shepherd as the tender, loving kindness of Jesus, right? Of Jesus holding the lamb. I think that's beautiful and shouldn't go anywhere. But the passage told me this week, in addition to the loving kindness, the relationship between the shepherd and the flock is unity of the flock, holding it together. So it's with this passage I learned some things about this stained glass window that I've been looking at for 10 years that I didn't know before. Maybe you guys already knew this, but I didn't. Do you know those sheep? They're from different backgrounds. They speak different languages. They have different politics. They cook different foods and wear different clothes, drive different vehicles. They do different things in the summer. One's a huge sports fan. The other's like, whatever, take me to the theater. One loves to stay out late. I think it's the one that's sitting in Jesus' arms. The other's into bed early, up with a book and a cup of coffee, watching the sun rise. They have disagreements over all kinds of things. Maybe that's why Jesus stands between them. My favorite sticks his tongue out, so he's a little rude. The other's more gentle. A couple of these sheep in his flock can stand on their own. A little bit of strength. The others, part of the same flock, needs extra love, care, and support. The primary purpose of this good shepherd is to hold the flock together and bring and call other sheep into his flock. Now, what does the shepherd do when the wolf comes disguised as self-interest? One flock, one shepherd. What happens when the wolf comes disguised as elitism or nationalism? The wolf comes described as racism. All kinds of forms of division and hatred, nationalism, classism. The wolf comes disguised as many things in our lives to separate us from each other and the shepherd. One flock, one shepherd. The love and activity, the mission of God is to call the family together, to bring them not uniformity, not all to look and think and speak and talk and believe the same things, right? To have the same opinions. That's uniformity. Jesus is interested in unity over division. If you've ever been ismed out of the flock, welcome back. If you've ever helped some other people think that they weren't a part of this flock, it's okay. Jesus forgives you, welcomes you back to the activity of our God is to hold us together as one family, one shepherd.
We pray that believe in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. We bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Shepherd. The nations and people are your heritage. Place into the hearts of all leaders and rulers the passion to serve. God, in your mercy.
Especially this evening tonight, we pray for Donna Splitstatzer, Lou Miller, Mary Hannah Tatana, Donette Cleaver, Les Hall, Kate Lair, Nikki Peterson, Michael Allard, Kay Schoenbeck, Susan Stefanowitz, and Amy Simmons. May your healing light shine upon them. We also pray for you and lift into your hands family and friends mourning the death of Reverend Lynn Ronsberg, Voma Renault, and Catherine Mardian.
Eternal Shepherd, you hold us securely in your loving hands. In the assurance of resurrection hope, we remember our loved ones who have died in you. Bring us with them to dwell in your house forever. In the hope of new life in Christ, we praise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Risen Christ be with you all. Let's take a moment in the sanctuary and online at home and share a sign of peace with one another. At this time, in our regular worship rhythm, we would collect an offering, but in lieu of passing the plates through the congregation in this time of COVID, you will find those offering plates at the exits of the sanctuary. If you've brought a gift with you tonight, you may leave it there. Thank you also for giving online and all the ways you contribute to the mission of the church. Thanks to you, we were able to feed over 500 people at our latest pop-up food pantry 2 weeks ago. So thank you for your support.
People get ready, there's a trainer coming. Don't need no baggage, just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesels humming. Don't need your ticket, just thank the Lord. People get ready. Train to Jordan, picking up passengers from coast to coast. Faith is key, open the door and board them. There's hope for all among the lovermost. The diesel.
some instructions for communion this evening. At this time, folks worshiping online can grab their bread and cup and get ready to say the words of institution with me. Folks in the sanctuary, we will need two communion assistants. If you'd like to gather in the back while I read the words of institution, we'd love to have you. And after the Lord's Prayer, you can come up to the front, just like we used to do it in the pre-COVID days. We will have folks come into the middle aisles, and you'll come to these two communion stations. Folks on the outer aisles, you'll come to the ones out here, and you will take your communion cup with the wafer sealed on top. Please take these back to your seat. If you'd like, you can commune in your seat, or feel free to take them home. As always, if you have folks at home who would like to receive communion and weren't able to join us tonight, please feel free to take extra and help us share the love of Jesus in the world. Thank you so much for helping us with that. Please rise as you are able. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray as one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the table. The shepherd is calling you. He knows you. Be one with him and your neighbor at this table of love. You may be seated.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer, Redeemer of the world, grant us comes, there will be no more doom. I pay
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus strengthen you and keep you in his grace and in his peace. Amen. A few announcements before we end worship this evening, this week. So there's a women's Bible study tomorrow. It will be on Zoom at noon. Even if you've never joined us before, you're more than welcome to come. Just shoot me an email if you'd like the Zoom link. You are welcome to take a lily home. This is the last week they'll probably be here. You can plant them if it ever stops snowing. They do quite well in a garden. Their VBS details are out, so if you are interested in joining VBS or helping with VBS, we would love to have you. See Chelsea for more details on that. There's no youth group tonight. Seventh graders, you'll be with me for confirmation in the fellowship hall. Sixth and eighth graders, you're in here with Pastor Joel over there. And eighth graders, don't forget, next week you will be going on the garbage cleanup, so don't forget to fill out the registration form and meet us at Cashwise next week. There'll be an email coming out about that as well. Please rise as you are able for a blessing. May the one who brought forth Jesus from the dead raise you to new life, fill you with hope, and turn your mourning into dancing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen. The band will play us out from Worship to the World. Christ is risen, just as he said. Go in peace. Live and love like Jesus. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.